you take me home, please, Mr. Ludden?
Saying good night,
everybody.
That's the trailblazing Connie Chung interviewing the legendary Marlon Brando. One of many memorable milestones in a long and accomplished career. I paid her a visit to catch up and look back.
Good evening. From CBS News, this is Newsbreak.
You know, when you're young and you don't know any better, I just plowed forward as if I knew what I was doing.
Stand by. Here we go.
And setting a pace for herself, nobody was going to outwork Connie Chung. Her career began with an entrance.
I barged into a local TV station. I can learn, I don't have experience, but I can do this job.
At home in Montana with her husband of nearly 40 years, daytime TV legend Maury Povich.
You are not!
She can enjoy the view and reflect on a four-decade career. Her new memoir is called Connie.
Let me tell you when we first realized that there was a Connie Chung.
Maury Povich was then a rising star in the newsroom.
She wanted a job, and the news director said, no, 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 you're my assistant. She said, no, I want that job, weekend writer on the news desk. And he said, well, then you have to replace yourself. She walks out of the newsroom, across the street, into the bank, looks at the first woman teller and says, you want to be in TV? Marched her across the street into the newsroom. She got the job, and the bank teller got the job as the secretary.
Soon she caught the eye of CBS News, barging into a restaurant cited for health violations with camera crew in tow.
Lo and behold, the CBS bureau chief was sitting there having lunch. He saw me, and he gave me his card, and he said, call me.
The CBS News Washington Bureau in 1971.
All I saw around me was what I call a sea of men. Mm-hmm.
Connie devised a survival plan.
I looked around and I said, well, heck, I'm going to be a guy too. So I took on their characteristics. I had bravado. I would walk into a room as if I owned it.
And she could talk like a sailor.
I had a body reputation for saying the unexpected to these men who were rather sexist and racist, and they were cool, but the bad words, not good. I don't recommend that to anyone.
Yeah.
It was just my MO of how to survive in that snake pit.
Moving up one step at a time. Wasn't enough for Connie Chung.
News, business, sports, and weather. Get it first, get it fast on
NBC wanted to hire somebody to do the half-hour news before the Today Show.
Sometimes.
And I said, I'll do that, but I also want to not just do that. I want to report political stories for Tom Brokaw's Nightly News, and I want to do the Saturday Night News, and I'd like to do news breaks at 9 and 10 p.m. That made it very difficult to sleep.
The people of Chile have rejected the continued rule of General Augusto Pinochet.
You seem to be a powerful hybrid of your Americanness, mm-hmm. and your Chinese. American opportunity.
Yes.
Chinese.
Dutiful. Always does the right thing. goody-two-shoes, respectful.
Ambition, drive?
Oh, yeah, you know.
Focus?
Yeah, sure. The drive to succeed. That was a combo platter.
In hyper-competitive network battles, the prize interview was the get. In November 1991, Magic Johnson, the great LA Lakers point guard, revealed he tested positive for HIV.
I will have to retire from the Lakers.
I went to his agent's office and squatted. I wouldn't leave until he left the office.
She got the interview.
Roger, how do you think you were infected?
Well, the doctor said that it's different than sex.
And the first interview with the captain of the Exxon Valdez.
Trust me, Paul.
No.
After the devastating Alaska oil spill.
Captain Hazelwood, were you drunk when you boarded the Exxon Valdez?
No.
But while the Tanya Harding skating scandal and moments with titillating titles deliver ratings.
Right. In the fat lane.
The taint of tabloid fare sullied her name and reputation.
It was story after story after story, and I just did not have the power to say no, and I so regret that, Jane.
The daughter of Chinese immigrants.
My parents were very, very traditional Chinese people.
Connie was the youngest of five sisters, the only one born in America. Her father decided she would be the son he never had and carry on the Chung name.
As of 4 o'clock this afternoon,
she exceeded his expectations and realized her own dream.
I'm thrilled.
Joining Dan Rather on the CBS Evening News in 1993.
Good evening. Welcome,
Connie. Thank you.
But it was not the dream team.
Do you remember the line from the Bette Davis movie?
It wasn't all about Eve.
Yes. And she's going up the steps and she says, fasten your seatbelts. It's going to be a bumpy night. And I thought, yep, hang on, honey.
Before we say goodnight, some news about ourselves.
After 2 years, she was fired.
I was crushed. Absolutely crushed.
But then, just days later, after years of miscarriages and infertility treatments, their adopted son was born.
And we got Matthew when he was less than a day old. He never left my arm, you know. He was an extension of my arm. And to this day, he's a grown man. And so wonderful.
At the age of 49, Connie almost had it all.
I could never declare success. I was born Chinese. I'm
never
born humble. Yeah, never enough.
And I think it took the Connie generation for her to realize exactly what she had become.
Last year, the New York Times published a story entitled Generation Connie. Chinese, Korean, and Japanese parents across the country had named their baby daughters after her.
I couldn't believe it. It was the most exhilarating day that I could have ever imagined.
Thank you.
It was they who declared me a success. And once they did that, I thought, really? I have to accept that.
What did you mean to their parents?
Work hard. Be brave and take risks. I wasn't the smartest. I wasn't the toughest. But those three things I did.
See you tomorrow.
We love you. We'll see you here on the Family Feud.
Show until next time. This is Peter Tomorrow on behalf of the Bukkake Rug saying thanks for pressing your luck. Bye bye.
So anyway, we have just 10 seconds to say goodbye. We'll see you tomorrow. So long.
Bye bye. Yeah.
We got 5 seconds.
Oh no, we have 3,
2, 1.
Bye.
Bye.